The following lesson is linked to learning outcome 2, reading and viewing, and addresses the assessment standard that requires learners to demonstrate various reading and viewing strategies for comprehension and appreciation. Learners should be able to read or view according to purpose or task. Hi there, my name is Becky, and I'd like to welcome you to our first series on Reading Our World. This is Ntabi, and she's going to come along with us today.
Hi.
We decided that it was time to get Ntabi out of the studio. Take a look around you. Where do you think we are today? As you can see, she's in a taxi, and she's been out on the road. In fact, we wanted to find out about viewing our world. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to explain how comprehension skills can be used for reading and viewing, explain how having a purpose or task helps when reading or viewing. So Ntabi, what do you do when you're in a taxi?
Well, it depends. Generally, I chat to the other passengers or even read a book. If I had to stay late at school, then I may even go to sleep on my way home.
What do you do when you're in a taxi? Do you chat to the other passengers? Do you sleep? Do you do your homework? Perhaps you do what we've just done. Look out at the window, at all there is to see in the world around us. So then, what do you see while you're driving? Make a list of all the things you remember seeing during our taxi trip. I don't know about you, but I remember seeing a big billboard. I also saw a Standard Bank sign on the side of a building. Let's find out from Ntabi what she saw.
I saw a sign for a doctor's surgery. I also saw a Woolworths and an Edgar's sign.
Perhaps you saw the same things that we saw, and perhaps you didn't. Some things may catch your eye because they're bright and stand out, but other things will catch your eye because of who you are and your own interests. I noticed the Standard Bank sign because this is where I bank. Why do you think you noticed the Woolworths and Edgar's signs, Ntabi?
That's easy. I'm a bit of a shopaholic. I always look out for shops, particularly clothing shops.
So you see, we notice certain things because we find them interesting. Make a list of the things that you tend to notice and then try to work out why you notice those things. Did you know that when you look out the window and watch the world, you're actually reading your world? It sounds a bit nuts, I know. But let me explain. When you read a book, you're making sense of what you see, namely the words and sentences. The words and sentences together give you information about the story. In exactly the same way, you can begin to understand your world by looking at it more closely, taking note of the images, words, and colors around you, and thinking about what they are telling you. So now you can see that the process of watching the world go by is actually a form of reading. When we read, we talk about comprehending what we have read. To comprehend something means to understand something, to make meaning of it. When viewing for comprehension, our text is what we see. Now let's see how much you comprehended from the trip we just took. Do you remember where we began? We began with cars, banks, large buildings, and shops all around us. So where could we have been? Did you see the first billboard? If your memory is really good, then you remember that it was a toothpaste advert. What did you see next? I saw a car park. And finally, what did you notice about the buildings around you? If you said that generally there were big, tall buildings with small shops on the roadside, then you were really watching. Well done. Now let's think about what all of this tells us about our trip. Firstly, our trip must have begun on the highway, as we were traveling fairly fast and had a number of other cars speeding past us. Secondly, we seem to be going towards a town or city, as we could see a number of big buildings alongside us. And thirdly, we must have traveled into the city, because we could see big shops, buildings, and many people walking along the roadside. See what I mean? Pretty amazing what you can comprehend just by viewing or watching the world around you. One of the ways that we can deepen our viewing skills is by knowing why we are viewing. This means having a purpose or reason for viewing. Can you think of some reasons for why we would watch the world carefully when traveling in a taxi? Well, Ntabi, do you have any ideas?
Yes, I do. Sometimes my purpose is for entertainment. I like seeing what's happening in the world around me, particularly if it involves my own neighborhood, such as a shop I should try. I also watch carefully if I don't know where I'm going. Then if I do get lost, I can hopefully try find my way home again.
Those are both great suggestions. In fact, let's try this experiment. Ntabi Seng is going to go on another journey. This time, she's on her way to a friend's house. She has never been to this friend's house before, so she needs to pay careful attention to the route and what she passes. So if she has to go there again, she'll be able to find it. So then, how was your trip different this time, Tabby? What kinds of things did you look out for?
I kept watching, hoping I'd see a street or suburb sign, but there weren't any. Normally, I'd look for the things I'm interested in, such as the clothing or shoe shops. But this time, I had to look at everything so I could get a sense of where I was and what kind of place it was.
So guys, what did you see that could help you to find your way back to that place again? Compare your thoughts about the taxi ride with a partner. Now let's see how having a purpose changes the way you look at things. Ntabi said that she had to look at everything so that she could understand where she was. So she was guided while she watched through the window. Consider these questions carefully. Did you notice the shops on the sides of the road? What kinds of shops were they? Were they big or small? Were they old or new? What kinds of things did they sell? What did you notice about the shop signs? Were the pavements clean or dirty? Were there lots of people out and about? What can you tell about the neighborhood from this information? Now use these questions to guide your viewing. Let's watch the trip again. We'll be right back. The answers to these questions should have helped you to develop a clearer picture of the neighborhood. Was there anything else that stood out for you at all?
I noticed that we turned around and traveled back on the same road again.
Well done. Yes, that is exactly what happened. Why do you think you noticed this?
Because I was paying so much attention to the shops on the side of the road, I noticed we were driving past them again.
So you can see that knowing why you're viewing is very important, as it changes the way in which you view and it gets you to see things in different ways. This is called viewing according to purpose or task, and you can do exactly the same thing when you're reading. Always make sure that you know why you're reading or viewing, that you have set yourself a purpose or task before you begin, and you'll find that you become far more critical of what you're seeing or reading. Well, guys, that's all we have time for today. Join us in our next episode where we'll be taking another road trip. Remember to keep your eyes wide open and enjoy reading your world.
Bye.